Hi, Snat. Sie haben das Deutsche, Sie haben Satzamtons und Snat, Daryl Hilaire. And I'm here with you tonight, bringing you One from the Heart, a program that we're starting here at Children of the Setting Sun to share in the world's trials, its tribulations, to show heartfelt empathy for those people that are perhaps suffering or have lost their loved ones, and to the rest of us to learn how to heal together, to share in that healing with song, with good words and good feelings, and then have a vision for this day of joy we'll have with one another when we can be together again to share a meal, to be together as family and friends and carry on the best way that we can. So thank you for joining us, Heischka. And at this time, I'd like to call on a new friend of mine. I know she'll be a good friend of mine here real soon, Cynthia Jim, to open us with the song. Heischka.
Thank you, Daryl, for having me. It's my mother's song called The Grandmother's Song. It hails from the Wanak and the Tsleil-Waututh people. And we share it with anybody that can hear it and anybody that learns it. You're welcome to sing it. Hey, hi, 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 hi.
Heichka, thank you so much for that opening song. At this time, I'd like to introduce other members of our team here, our family, have them introduce themselves to you, the future hosts of this program, Jay Julius and Bella James and TJ Adams. We also have Mike Bandiola, who couldn't be with us tonight. He'll join us at a future date. But I'd like to start with Jay, if you could step forward and say a few words.
Thank you. Thank you, Setting Sun Productions, and thank you to the team. Thank you, everyone watching. Grateful for family today, grateful for so much, and just throwing up a prayer every day for the elders and the vulnerable, and I encourage everyone to do the same. So thankful for our doctors, our frontline workers, our nurses, our young ones who are helping the elders, delivering food. Just thankful for so much today, and trying to keep an eye on the positive during these times. And thankful for our leadership taking the advice from our experts and really moving fast in a good direction for our people here at Lummi Nation and all throughout the county. Hold close to family. Thank you, Daryl, for hosting this during these times. I'm glad we're going to be able to share some thoughts and some hope and bring some optimism during these times and share some laughter together as well. It's an honor to be here tonight. Thank you.
Ashka J. Isabella James, you want to introduce yourself?
My native name is Quintia. And my name is Isabella James. I want to thank everyone for listening today, and just want to thank everyone for taking this so seriously. Everyone on Facebook has been saying stay home, and you know, think about our elders and think about our young ones, and even think about you know, the ones that are about to be, or the ones that are pregnant and are about to have babies come into the world. You know, that's really important to keep all those people safe, and you know, not to go out and do what we usually, you know, not what we usually do, but you know, what everyone usually does, and just to stay home and not to be going out and about, you know, like we've been home all this week and last week. So it's been pretty different, big change, you know, for everybody, definitely. So, yeah. Thank you.
Ashka Bella. Okay, TJ Adams, you want to step forward and share some words?
Yeah, can you hear me?
Sure can.
Hey, my name's Kateluk. I come from Lummi Nation. My borrowed name's Terrence Adams. My parents are Penny Carroll Hilaire and Joe Adams. And I work for the tribe as a culture advocate through Lummi Victims of Crime. Do a lot of awareness and service work within our school for bullying and stalking and dating violence, and that's really where my passion's at with the school, with the kids, and that's kind of where I feel comfortable. And it's very important that we get this message of unity and being together, you know, as one. That's what our elders taught us, you know, to be together. I always go to that teaching from one of my dads, you know, us as a community, us as one, as a kindling. We're all our own kindling, our own family within our community, but as together, you know, we become the cedar tree and strong. And you know, as long as we're strong and be that cedar tree for our youth, our future, you know, we always have a strong and healthy future with whatever's put in our way. My late grandmother always taught us, you know, the Lord would never give us nothing we can't handle. So as long as we believe in our teachings, our ways, and reassure our people, our elders and our kids, you know, all of our elders, my father and my mother are both elders, and it's scary trying to get them to go home. My mom's accustomed to helping her people and helping her kids, and that's what means the most to her right now. And my father, same thing. And it's very big that we use this, you know. So many times our elders tell us social media is stay away from it, and now we need to use it for a tool, you know. It's just another tool that we have in our tool belt to help educate our people and bring us together in this time of need. I just really encourage the social distancing, coastal jams and the powwows. I've seen grass dancers, our natives across in the plains, you know, doing their thing to spread their wellness. And with that, I'm just happy to be here and excited to get on this canoe and ride this wave of healing and unity. Osiem.
Oh, Haishka nephew, Haishka, all of you that are going to join in this broadcast. And now I'd like to share a little story about that leads into this song that we're going to share with you. Way back in the beginning of Indian gaming, Lummi needed some help to transition out of its old casino into the new one we have today. And we didn't have the resources at that time, but we went down to the Viejas band of Indians who are part of the Kumeyaay people. And we went there to ask them for help. And they gave us that help. They shared with us a little bit of their wealth so Lummi can get back on its feet. And the chairman at that time was Anthony Pico, Chairman Anthony Pico, a great leader and a great believer in sovereignty, a great fighter for Indian rights clear across this country. He's a good friend of the Lummi people, the Lummi leaders that have come up through the generations. And he always speaks highly of us, and we speak highly of him and his people. Well, I asked him to be on the program with us tonight, but he couldn't because he just lost his mother-in-law. So I told him that I would play one of his songs for him in honor of him and his people tonight. So at this time, we'd like to share a song from the Bird Singers, who visited us a few years ago in honor of one of our great leaders. So at this time, we'd like to share that with you. Siam Niselicha.
I'm Kowey, I'm Kowey, I'm a Kaliwande, Kaliwande. 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 I'm Kowey, I'm Kowey, I'm a Kaliwande, Kaliwande, Kaliwande. I'm Kowey, I'm Kowey.
What a beautiful song. And this goes out to you, Brother Anthony. As we move along here, I wanted to share a little bit about our future programming. Tonight, we're just bringing some of our people together to share what's on their heart, but we're going to continue to do that, but also bring music and poetry into the program, probably have one night of that. And we'll be asking Mark Nichols and Eliza and Cynthia and a few others, Keith, to join in bringing that night together, putting that night together. And we'll get that out to you before we do that. And we also are asking TJ and Jay to reach out into our community and to other tribal communities and places throughout the country, people that they know that can talk to us about the issues, about the feelings, about what's going on in their communities, so we can all join in creating this this call for unity. And then we're going to be asking Ellie and Michelle Pulaski, Kyla Pulaski, Isabella James, all of the youth podcast team to put together our elders programs, our elders and youth can talk with one another, listen to one another, make plans together for our families. And as we all know, the mother and the grandmothers are the heart and soul of our families. So we want to make sure that we pick that up in this conversation we're having today to continue, as Bella was saying, take care of our young ones, even the unborn. We cannot forget the unborn. So, and then also we want to try to insert some fun into what we're doing, and we'll try different things. We might try some improv comedy. We might bring on some comedians, if you will. I know we have a good friend in Colville, Vaughn Eaglebear, who I talked to last night, and he'd love to be part of a program here to tell jokes and to share funny stories and to bring his friends in to what we're trying to do here. But we also have things that we can do ourselves to remain active. And we have a friend here, his name is Daniel Innett, who is going to give us a little juggling lesson. So, Daniel, you're on.
Hello, everybody. Such a pleasure to be here. What an honor. Thank you so much. I love to teach people how to juggle because I love that, for me, the expansion of what is possible. You know, we take it from impossible to I'm possible. And I've taught many, many people to juggle. And I'd like to help bring you all a little bit more towards that. You all can use at home, you can find, let's see, tennis balls work really good, especially if you cut a little slit in them and like fill them with gravel sometime. Or if you just need, in a pinch right now, ball up some socks. They're a little light, but they can be good. Or anything else you find at hand, you can give it a shot. The ideal thing is something about this big, it's a little something that fits in your hand. And the way to start is you start with just one ball and you go from hand to hand. And I find that the ideal thing is to just throw hand to hand and try to throw it about forehead level. It's tempting to start really tiny like that because, you know, it's under control. But if you go a little bit bigger, when you have more balls in the air, you'll have more time. But if you go too big, then they get kind of wild and go all over the place. So one ball back and forth, about forehead level, works really good. And first you just practice with that. And I usually have people try to do that at least 10 times in a row without dropping. So you count. And then once you've done it 10 times in a row without dropping, you can move on to two. And I want to point out something that a lot of people, when they start to juggle, they think they want to juggle and they throw one and then a hand across, throw and hand across. And that is a kind of juggling. But with three, that ends up being really hard. It's a trick that you can learn, but an easier way to juggle is to actually do two throws and then two catches. So the mantra, the juggling mantra when you're beginning is throw, throw, catch, catch. So we go like this. We go throw, throw, catch, catch. Throw, throw, catch, catch. And you kind of imagine that the balls are going to do an X in front of your body. So they're going here, and then the other one's coming underneath. Throw, throw, catch, catch. Let's throw, throw, catch, catch. Throw, throw, catch, catch. Just like so. Throw, throw, catch, catch. So again, about forehead height, the balls are kind of forming an X. And so you throw one and you make sure the other ball goes underneath it. So you're throwing one ball in the air and it's coming down. And so you have that ball in the hand. So you have to get rid of that ball. So you throw the other one in order to catch the other one. So you throw, throw, catch, catch. And then once you've done that at least 10 times, you can move on to juggling three. And if you find you're having a lot of trouble with the three, you can always go back down to two and work on two for a while until you really get that in your body. And all of that practice, you know, it's like there's actually a science behind it of like every time we fire those muscular neurons, they wrap more insulation around themselves. So they fire cleaner and faster and more efficiently. So the very repetition of it always leads to being better at it. So with three, it's actually just like two. You're going throw, throw, catch, catch. But the thing is that when you have the one in the air and then you have to throw the next one to get rid of it, then that one's coming down and you still have one in the other hand. So you have to throw again. So it's going throw, throw, catch, catch, throw, throw, catch, catch, just over and over and over again in a row. And then away you go. And it took me, you know, some people I'm able to teach to juggle in an hour or so, or in half an hour, and it's amazing. And I love to juggle. It's something I've done for a decade at least. But it took me at least a week or two of working at it pretty, you know, a lot each day. So if you're having trouble, don't get discouraged. It's really brought a lot of joy to my life. And I hope that with all this newfound time on your hands, you might consider investing some in learning the joy of juggling. And that does it for the short mini lesson, I think. I'll just do a few tricks here just to perhaps inspire. You can get on to all kinds of different interesting things once you get going. Thank you.
Ishka. Well, cool. I thought you were going to start playing there, TJ, but I guess not. This time we'd like to have a little conversation. If there's anybody that'd like to join in and maybe offer some perspectives or maybe some feedback you're receiving from your friends online or people passing notes to you. Why don't we start with maybe Cynthia, if you could share a little bit about what we're doing.
Oh, yes, back to me. I have a little bit of background noise here. What was your question again, Daryl?
Oh, this is kind of our feedback time. If you have any feedback or if you want to add anything, any comments.
Okay.
Even a song, if you'd like, that'd be fine.
It's such a privilege any time that we communicate with one another. And my grandmother always said, be careful what you feed because that's what grows. So what we want to feed is all this beautiful things in life and pass that on to other people in the best way we know how. And I just want to thank everybody out there for, you know, for tuning in and for joining us for a little bit of just, you know, lifting the spirits and connecting in some form. Life is about learning. We're all learning all the time. And it's okay to make mistakes and to keep on going. It's how many times you stand up. It's not how many times you fall down. And I want to give just all my blessings to the community out there and all my love. And I'll sing some prayer songs tonight with my daughter Raven's here with me. I've been isolated here for almost 2 weeks with my daughter and my son back from university. And my other two sons and a daughter. So it's been quite wonderful to spend time and get to know each other all over again.
Awesome. So
thank you. Kokshtam.
Atsiam. Jay, you want to add something?
Sure. Thanks, Daryl. again, it's just it's great to be sharing some time with everyone and say hello to the kids. It's really shed light on how much time we need to be spending with our family. This has created an opportunity. I'm really staying positive through this current time and crisis we're in, and trying to figure out what we have to be thankful for, and what are the opportunities? How can we grow from this? Where can we help during these times? And where are the elders that we could be helping, the younger generation? And just thankful to everyone who's practicing the social distancing, taking into consideration the vulnerable during these times. And one thing I think we're going to talk about later on in the show, Daryl, is Mother Earth. And I think Mother Earth is really, during these times, is celebrating, because we see on the news and we read about the climate that is being, it's actually helping climate right now. It's helping Mother Earth. And I think her hands are up. And thankful for these times, because we are resting, we are all at home, and Mother Earth is really benefiting from this. So really something to take into consideration, and I think for our government nationally and locally to really take a hard look at, and I think we should all have a conversation about that and gather the data that's being taken right now during these times. And it's important for our future generations, for the unborn, and because they're the ones who are gonna have to live through the consequences of what we're doing today and yesterday. So just honored and privileged to be here. Thank you. Thank you to everyone for watching, and stay hopeful, stay optimistic, and pray for the vulnerable. Haishka.
Thank you, Jay. I think Ellie's on here somewhere, if she's got anything to say or if she received any comments from people. Did she disappear? Okay, anybody else? TJ, you want to add something?
John has to. Yeah. First and foremost, I want to thank the sister for offering up the prayer for our gathering here tonight. And I hope everybody at home, in good heart, good spirit, is enjoying their time with their family and their kids. And in continuous prayer for my people. You know, I come from the Lummi Nation, and we're a tight-knit community. And working really hard to make sure that, you know, there's no panic, or, you know, I'm just learning about this myself. I can really say at the beginning of this social distancing, you know, I'm still learning, you know, like a little kid, you know, I was taught to give hugs and say, hey, hi, how you doing? And my late grandfather always taught me, you know, if you didn't make somebody smile, grandson, you're not doing something right, because that's your gift. So, you know, I get carried away sometimes, but at times laughter is what's saving us. You know, I try to remind myself, and who is it going to be tough for, you know, being at home with your family when you're used to your schedule, going to work and coming home, and you know, how do we really show our kids, really show social distancing and understanding what it means? But these are great things going across Indian country, man. These coastal jam outs and people sharing songs. You know, I had a brother across the border there, and they were part of a round dance. You know, these gathered Indian natives are in these social distance challenges, grass dances, getting outfitted and going in their backyard and ripping it up. And you know, that's what it's about, and having this love and this laughter and always bringing this unity, this togetherness, because even though my mother's on the end of the, she still calls me and I still call her. I still worry about her. She still worries about me. At times like this, it's very important to check in and communicate. Check on your loved ones. My Uncle Henry, you know, those old timers, it's hard to get them to keep still, you know? And so we're telling them, hey, you know, it's time to stay home, Mom. It's time to stay home, Dad, you know? And it's tough because I'm right there wanting to grab the keys. And so this is very big and it's very eye-opening for myself to be a part of this. I'm very fortunate for my uncle to allow me to come in and share the tools that I have in my tool belt and in my treasure chest, because they're for my people and for me to share with my people, you know? And so very huge what we got going on here, and I hope that we can continue to have these. I'm very excited for other ones to come in the future. OCM. Hey, I found a buddy right here. We're right here in Bigfoot country. OCM.
You got anything, Ellie?
Oh, yeah. Can y'all hear me?
Yep.
Oh, hi, everyone. I was going to read questions if anyone had them. So go ahead and type your questions in. In the meantime, I'd like to say hi to Troy Boy, who I hear is watching. Also, see my friend Mick from Australia is joined. We'd love to have original voices from the other end of the globe. So if we can organize a global movement of Indigenous voices, will only make us stronger. So we'll check in about that. I'll just give 1 minute if anyone wants to write any questions in. If not, I'd just like to say it's good to be here virtually and hope to one day be able to, you know, have human contact again. So I like what Jay was saying, that Mother Earth is healing, and we can just all do our part to contribute to that. So I'll check one more time to see if anyone has anything to say. Just a lot of love. So hi, Nessa. Hi, Andrea. Marsha. Francis Lewis. Elijah. Woo-woo. Got to get Elijah on this show. Tanya Teton. Anyway, good to see everyone, and over and out.
Looks like Brother Ray Harris has been watching us, so I'm glad he's there, and we're going to be calling upon him real soon. We're going to Zoom him next week if we can. Okay, at this time, we're going to move into what's next, which is Wednesday. We'll come back online with another program, a little more conversation, song, ceremony, if you will, and wisdom. So thank all of you, and we'll be back Wednesday right here. And before we sign off, I'd like to call on fine young man, Keith Jefferson, if you'd offer a closing song for us at this time. Siam Nistel Chahishka.
Hi, Siam. I just want to introduce my indie name. I carry two indie names. The first one, it's my main one, it's Hoxleton. The other one I carry is Theocton. I just want to thank you, everybody, for coming in to listen, taking your time, even though we're not too busy. It's even though we're all here listening, but thank you. ACM. Oh.
Aishka, I'd like to thank you. Thank all of you, Cynthia and Jay and TJ, Keith and Bella, Ellie Smith, Mark Nichols, Natasha Fry, and everybody put their hands together for John Carroll, who's in the Nerve Center making all this all happen for us. So Aishka, thank all of you, and we'll see you Wednesday.